उत्सि देयुरिमे लोकाः न कुर्याम कर्म चेदहम् संकरस्य च कर्तास्याम् उपहन्यामिमा प्रजाः.
If I were not to act, these worlds would get destroyed. I would cause chaos in society and ruin these people. So Krishna notices that there is a slight reaction from Arjuna to verse 23, where he instills fear. So he hammers it in. And the last resort is issuing a threat. So the threat is that if I were not to act, these worlds would be destroyed. As we've seen earlier, worlds means at a superficial level, it means heaven, earth and hell. But in the philosophical sense, it means waking, dream and deep sleep state. So, the devastating consequences of not acting is what he's pointing out to. Is not only if Krishna doesn't act, but if Arjuna doesn't act, it will have a terrible effect in society. So, what he's saying here, and then he continues, I would cause chaos in society and ruin these people. So, the devotional approach is Krishna is that power that is maintaining everything, that's keeping everything going. So if Krishna were to disappear, what would happen to the world? But the intellectual thing is that there are laws functioning in the world. Meticulously, diligently, not even once do they falter. Chemical laws, physical laws, biological laws, the whole world is meshed together through an intricate system of laws. These laws have been put in place by Brahman, Krishna. So if Krishna were not to play his role, all these laws would go berserk. Can you imagine you walk out of the auditorium this evening and instead of walking, you end up floating in the air? Terrible. So that's the chaos that we would cause externally. But even internally, the internal laws are the law of karma, the gunas, sattva, rajas and tamas, and the four castes. The four castes are not what is understood now. It's not a hereditary plan. It is the combination of sattva, rajas and tamas that is prevailing in you as an individual. So a Brahmin, a Brahmana is not the son of a Brahmin. The father may be a Brahmin. But depending on the proportion of the gunas in the son, then you would determine whether the son is a Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya or Shudra. So who is a Brahmana? A Brahmana is one who is predominantly sattvic, has a little bit of rajas and traces of tamas. A Kshatriya is one in whom sattva drops drastically. He is predominantly rajasic, has a little bit of sattva and tamas creeps in. Vaishya, the trader class, is one who in whom sattva drops still further and tamas rises alarmingly. And finally, Shudra is one who is predominantly tamasic, has a little bit of sattva and traces, has a little bit of rajas, and traces of sattva. So you need to go home and give a little thought on what is my constitution. And depending on that constitution, you should prescribe yourself a vocation, a profession that is in line with your gunas. Because a highly sattvic individual is one who naturally takes to the fields of pure science, music, teaching, philosophy, art, because he's contemplative by nature, creative by nature. Now, if you take a Brahmana and ask him to do an MBA and do business, he'll be a complete failure. That's what's happening. Kshatriya is one who is predominantly rajasic. Rajas prevails in such a person. So he must be, he naturally takes to the fields of administration, ruling, fighting meaning not just fighting, but kshatriya, armed forces, so on and so forth. By the time you come to Vaishya, there's so much tamas in him that all that he does is like typical stockbroking. You make money on somebody else's hard work. So you do business. And Shudra is predominantly tamasic. But the beauty of this whole pattern is such that it's been devised to help each individual, never mind what his constitution is. You could be a Shudra, but the whole system is devised to promote and encourage every individual to improve and rise to the highest level of development, which is enlightenment. Now, if this were not to take place, if this were not in balance, then there would be confusion. What is this balance? You look at the world, there seems to be a perfect balance between, for instance, carpenters, electricians, professors, business people, artists, chefs, musicians, all these various professions taken together make a homogeneous society. Have you ever wondered what would happen if there were no electricians in the world? Or no automobile engineers in the world? It never happens. That imbalance never takes place. It all falls in place. How? There is some force behind it all. What he's saying is, the threat that he's issuing is, if this balancing does not take place, in other words, if Brahman decides to switch off, there would be utter chaos and confusion in the world. With this, Arjuna seems to have woken up.